morning we do road clearing, which would be that we go out with machetes, clearing the road. We basically clear the roads, not obviously just for the vehicles, but it's to actually get access to the reserve so that we can get into parts for anti-poaching purposes. And then obviously the other aspect of it is to actually do a lot of monitoring. So for instance, we do predator monitoring. Large herbivore monitoring would be the rhinos, the elephant, all of that, collecting data on their movement, their feeding patterns, and generally getting as much data as we can, which then helps us to make management decisions to actually run the reserve.
You have a wildlife rehabilitation center as well,
which that is different. So the rehab center main function there is to the animals that we get in is then to try and get them out back into the wild again.
So an average day, if you like, is hard labour in one half of the day, and the other half of the day is taken over by the monitoring side of stuff and picking up locations of species. The rhino, obviously, the most important part of that is to know where they are on a regular basis so that we can map their movements. So when we're monitoring, it's not just a matter of sitting at a sighting. You're not here for game drives. You're here on a basis of being able to look out and look out for the animals. If we go predator monitoring, or more often than not, we're looking at the health of the cheetahs or the leopard or the lions, and you can often find a problem with the animals when you're doing the monitoring because you get to know them and see them. So you spot whether they've got a limp, or you spot whether there's an eye that's sore. And those sort of pieces of information are valuable to the wildlife team. So,
and if you do find that an animal has got an injury, what would be, would you be involved in taking it to the vet?
Potentially, that's the vet's call. That's totally the vet's call. More often than not, the lead coordinator will get in touch with our wildlife vet, advise of the problem. He'll probably go and suss it out himself, so he'll go and have a look first, and then manage the treatment, say what's needed. If we need to dart the animal and capture it, more often than not, the volunteers will be involved.
Have you been teaching volunteers some things about the tracking?
Absolutely. Because if you think about it, the tracking skills have been disappeared in the last decade. And to have that skill and to also to have that knowledge and to be able to pass on to other people, it's an amazing thing.
Would you recommend this project to other volunteers?
100%. 100%. It's not about a touchy-feely program. It's actually about contributing. It's about understanding what conservation is.